Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the general manager of Raw, Brad Maddox. Good evening. I am the general manager of Monday Night Raw, Brad Maddox, and it is my pleasure to introduce to you your WWE World Heavyweight Champion, the Viper, Randy Orton.
I hear voices in my head. They counsel me. They understand. They talk to me.
Indeed, he is still the WWE World Heavyweight Champion in a match against John Cena last night at the Royal Rumble event. But King Randy Orton is lucky he's still champion. John Cena had him in the STF. It looked like Orton was about to tap out before the lights went out, and we saw the Wyatts appear.
The Wyatts appeared, and as heard, I, along with everybody in the arena, said, why? I mean, I couldn't figure it out. Who were the Wyatts out here to go after? And turned out to be John Cena.
Well, Randy Orton had some choice words about Bray Wyatt earlier on in the night. So we thought Bray was coming out to target Randy Orton. The Wyatts would then turn their attack on John Cena. Again, we don't know why, but John, I think you'll agree, Orton's lucky he's still champion today.
I think Orton is lucky he's still champion. He was facing a great champion in John Cena, but Randy Orton took advantage of the opportunity.
And again, Randy Orton, the WWE World Heavyweight Champion. But we learned earlier tonight that he has to defend that title now next month inside Elimination Chamber.
Yeah, that's going to be very interesting.
Yeah.
We got some other stipulations about that match coming up. You're right, King, and Randy certainly cannot be happy about that.
The champ is here. Now, despite what most of you thought was going to happen last night, I beat John Cena yet again and walked out the Royal Rumble with these two titles in my grasp. Some of you say it was a hollow victory, but I don't give a damn. That doesn't matter. What matters is that I won. And then I get to work this morning, and I find out that in less than a month's time, I'm to defend my title against five other superstars at the Elimination Chamber. What kind of garbage is that, Brad? Was that your idea? The authorities? Huh? Listen, I demand a little respect, right? I'm the champion of champions. I'm the face of the WWE. Not Batista, not Brock.
Oh, my God. There is the man who last night won the Royal Rumble match. Batista will headline WrestleMania in the main event for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. The Animal's back. King, what an incredible performance last night in the Royal Rumble match for Batista.
Absolutely. Anytime you win a Royal Rumble, that's an incredible performance.
It came down to Batista and the upstart Roman Reigns from The Shield. But in the end, Batista won his second Royal Rumble match.
One of only four other people to win multiple Royal Rumbles.
Orton's livid that Batista's out here right now.
Congratulations, Randy. I mean that, man. That was a hell of a performance last night. Hell of a match. But like I told you last week, I'm back for three reasons. To win the Royal Rumble, to headline WrestleMania, and to walk out of WrestleMania the WWE World Heavyweight Champion. Two down, one to go. So I don't care who I face at the Superdome. I don't care if it's you. It's not personal. I don't care if it's John Cena. I don't care if it's The Shield. And I don't care if it's Daniel Bryan. And I definitely don't care if it's the winner of the Elimination Chamber match. So on April 6th, I don't care whether you or the Authority like it or not, I'm walking out of WrestleMania, WWE World Heavyweight Champion, and nothing is going to change that.
Now, this is unexpected.
Ladies and gentlemen, what an incredible moment. Orton, Batista, Lesnar, same place, same time. And King, what about what Brock Lesnar did to Big Show last night at the Royal Rumble?
A severe beatdown. It was almost criminal.
I've never seen anybody beat the Giant like Brock Lesnar did last night.
Brock Lesnar with a steel chair, leaving Big Show helpless.
Chairs, Michael. Chairs.
Well, you can tell by the look on Lesnar's face, that's ancient history as far as he's concerned. He's after one thing.
Mr. Maddox, my name is Paul Heyman. And sir, I stand before you tonight as the advocate for Brock Lesnar. My client, sir, has authorized me to inform you respectfully that his patience is running thin, which means Mr. Lesnar has asked me to tell you that you need to go back to the Authority and let them know that tonight they have two choices. See, choice number one is, since you're the general manager and I'm a promoter, I get to say to you, Mr. Maddox, let's make history here tonight, right here in Cleveland, Ohio. And you authorize a match with the reigning, defending WWE World Heavyweight Champion Randy Orton in a title match against the Beast Incarnate, Brock Lesnar! Now, just so you know, my client is not an unreasonable man, Mr. Maddox. So, we're not demanding, we're just suggesting. So there's an alternative, because choice number two is that you put the obvious number one contender, Brock Lesnar, against the so-called number one contender, Batista. Personally, I like both suggestions, but it's not up to me, sir, because ultimately, no matter which choice Triple H and Stephanie make, the ultimate winners are the WWE Universe. And therefore, my client wants Triple H and Stephanie's answer tonight, or else.
Brad Maddox has been between a rock and a hard place. What's it gonna be? He has to pitch either Lesnar versus Orton or Lesnar versus Batista tonight.
I would not take the or else option.
Randy Orton just shaking his head in disbelief. Not happy. Well, what a main event we have for you tonight here live on Monday Night Raw. One of these three men will qualify.